Hello, class 5. Today we are going to start with our English prose term 1. The lesson name is Earth, the Desolated Home. Before starting the lesson, children, let's see the classroom. Sol means Martian solar day, a Martian day it's called as. As we have an Earth 24 hours, in Mars, it's called as Martian day. A capsule means a small cylinder-shaped bed. The word hab means habitat or human settlement. Fuels means an energy force for machines, for engines, power plants or reactors. The word adapting means to modify, to get adjusted or readjust. Survival, to remain alive. The word terraform means process by which the surface and climate would be changed to make the environment suitable to humans. The word scientist means an expert in science. Let me give you a gist of this lesson, children. This lesson, Earth, the Desolated Home, is about a grandfather and a child. Okay, as in our land, in Earth, we have lost everything, right? People are cutting down the trees, destroying the birds, destroying the animals, and everything is being vanished up. And so, the Earth is demolished. Earth is destroyed. Okay, and so, it is just an imagination in the story about after few years, that is after 2068. There's still more 68 years ago, after 68 years ago, what's going to happen? This is just a imagination of that, and the writer has shared it with us. Okay, let's see the lesson. Earth, the Desolated Home. What is the meaning of desolated? Desolated means where there are no living inhabitants. Where there is no inhabitants living, everything is destroyed and demolished. Okay. Let us read the lesson. It was the year 2068. Humans had destroyed the Earth and started colonizing the red planet Mars. India established 3 colonies. Arimadhu's family lived in one such colony. On her birthday, her grandfather traveled more than 1,500 kilometers to meet her. When he reached, he saw her sleeping in a capsule. He said, "Wake up, Arimadhu." Arivamadi was surprised. "Grandpa, when did you come? I was thinking that you won't be coming for my birthday." He sighed. "Don't you know about the dust storm of Mars? Sometimes it even lasts for a month. But this time it did not. So I am on time. It still took me 3 souls to reach here. Now, come on, let's not waste time. We will go to the harvest. The vegetation hub for vegetables." Let me explain this paragraph. It was about 2068 years after humans had destroyed everything. Yeah, manidargal 2068 la ellathiyume destroy panitaanga. Humans had destroyed the trees, birds, plants, everything. Once the earth is destroyed, earth destroy aagnonne, what will happen? There is no life in Earth, and so man started living in Mars. Man left Earth and went to stay in Mars. Okay, and so in Mars they were living in colonies. Okay, and so Arivamadi's family was living in such colony, and so his grandfather was somewhere else. So as it was his birthday, Arivamadi's birthday, he was waiting for his grandma, and his grandma came there, and so together they went, okay, and in search of the harvesting means aruvadai. Okay, they are going to harvest the vegetables. Okay, and so let's read the next paragraph. Let's continue. In the hub, he said, "These carrots are not tasty anymore, like the ones I ate in my childhood." She asked, "Why do you say so, Grandpa?" Grandfather explained, "Vegetables we grow here do not taste like the ones on Earth. I really wish you had tasted the carrots from Earth." Arivu asked eagerly, How did they grow the crops and vegetables on the earth? Let me explain this, Tara. In the hub, he said, Grandfather and the child was talking to each other. Grandfather said, see, this carrots over here, which is from the Mars, is not at all fresh. It is not tasty at all. You should have tasted the ones which was on earth. So in earth, we have vegetation, right? Okay, naturally, God has gifted us with vegetation. But in Mars, they are trying to grow the vegetation. Okay, so grandfather is saying, the vegetation or vegetables which we get from earth are tastier than the one which we get from the Mars. And the child is asking, how did you grow the vegetables? Okay, he's asking his grandfather, how did you grow the vegetables in earth? Now let's continue. The next para. Now the grandfather was sad, like he is missing the earth. He said, the earth had fertile soil. The fruits and vegetables grown were healthy and tasty. She asked, but I learned that humans used chemical fertilizers and polluted the soil. Here we get unpolluted food and water. Is that correct? Said the grandchild. Grandfather laughed. Already I told you, these fruits, vegetables and water are not the same as in earth. They are not real. Arivu exclaimed. Even the water, he said. Of course. In Mars, we get water from burning fuels. On Earth, we used to get water from rain. It was natural. And it was free. She said, Grandpa, enough of your stories about the Earth. I know that life there was easy. But here, survival is very difficult. He replied, yes, my dear, adapting to Mars is difficult. Today, we are fighting for things which we get easily. Let me explain the para. Here again, it's a conversation between grandfather and the girl. Okay? And she says, as grandfather was feeling as if he's missing the earth, grandfather vandu earth romba miss pannanga because earth la everything you get naturally. Vegetables and fruits are grown naturally. Okay? And the things which you are grown naturally are tastier than the one which is artificially grown. So the grandfather is telling the child, see, in earth we had everything free. The water what we get was from the rain. And here on Mars, okay, you get water through the burning fuels. Okay. And the grandfather and the child was comparing the earth and the Mars. Grandfather was telling everything what we get on earth. Unpolluted water, okay, we get food naturally. The trees, the air, everything he was explaining. But Arivumadi was surprised to see that. And he said, and she said that, oh, is that so? In earth, do you get all this? But I heard that people on earth have destroyed the soil. They have used chemical fertilizers and have destroyed the soil. Okay. Let's continue. Para. He continued. The grandfather continued. In the earth, you did not need a space suit or an oxygen cylinder. Also, the ears are long here. Arivu said, yes, Grandpa. In Mars, 687 days make a year. He smiled. Ha ha, yes. You could be 18 years older on the earth now. Grandpa thought himself, we destroyed our home. Humans have destroyed everything. The home that nature had us offered us. Now we are trying to make this our home. Arivu looked at him and said, don't worry, Grandpa. The scientists are trying to terraform the Mars. He said, true, but nothing can be like Earth. The Earth is our home. Oh, let us leave this for now. Today we should celebrate. Let me explain this para. This para too. Arivu and her grandfather were talking to each other. Grandfather was so much missing the Earth and he said, see, we do not use a space suit or oxygen cylinders. As we used to get earth, in earth, we used to get air from the fresh trees. Okay. And we used to get everything fresh in the earth, the water, which we used to get from the rain, the birds, the trees, the flowers, everything was fresh. And here in Mars, it takes 687 days to make 1 year. While on earth it is 365 days make a year, and you would have been 18 years old if you would have been on earth. And so grandfather thought to himself and told, see, man has destroyed a home. He was so selfish that he has destroyed the nature, but nature has given us everything. But still, man did not realize that and destroyed the nature. Arivu was thought, okay, now grandfather is sad, and so he told him, don't worry, grandpa. The scientists are trying to transform the Mars into Earth. Then Arivu said, even though if they are trying to change the Mars into Earth, it's not going to be like the Earth. It is not going to be the real home for us. Okay. Then grandfather was sad that man has destroyed everything for his purpose and he has destroyed the earth. Children, what do we learn from this story, children? Yes. We people have got everything from God naturally, right? Trees, the flowers, the birds, the water, everything, which we should not destroy, nor should we spoil them. It is God's gift to us, and so we should save them, right? Yes. Thank you, children. God bless you.